was sad as shit to leave Australia, knowing exactly what lay ahead of us.
It's time to return on tour with Slayer to Europe.
Europe in the winter is really shitty, no matter where you go.
To get there from Australia, if you pull out your globes now, you'll see Australia down here. I think it was Perth that we might have flown from. We flew from Perth to Singapore. Long flight.
We go from Singapore to London.
From London to Milan. With maybe an hour and a half to 2 hours in between all of that.
And then we get to Italy, finally. And, like, it felt like someone just dropped us in a mud puddle.
We land, and we get picked up by the same bus that we were in on the Philadelphia tour, where Mark and Randy were in a fight. Talk about bad vibes, man. I mean,
it was like a huge morale crusher.
To get back on the same fucking bus that inspired us to start throwing fists at each other. Pretty fucking lame.
My shoulder hurts.
Thrilled. My eye is swelling shut as we speak.
It was like the mood did a 180-degree turn.
So was that.
We went from, like, paradise to, you know, back in the trenches.
What's wrong with my look? No, it's just good. The whole Unabomber, sexy glasses.
Same shorts for 3 months.
This guy. Same, no deodorant. Shirt wearing.
Yeah, deodorant's for metrosexuals.
Deodorant's exactly. For... dudes that don't want to offend other dudes.
That's my thing, is offending other dudes.
We're stuck on this bus in here from 8 o'clock until tomorrow morning. It's going to suck.
Yeah. Now we're wired and exhausted at the same time.
Shut up!
There's just nothing around and nothing to do. There's like highways to go down both sides of this place. There's nothing to do.
Randy snuck some whips through customs. We're bored out of our freaking minds. And Willie decides he wants to learn how to be a whipperist.
Yeah, it's a field thing. You just do it so you turn it around and then...
I'm trying to teach Willie how to crack the thing. And he's just beating the shit out of himself with it. The crack at the end of it is the tip of it breaking the sound barrier. It's a mini sonic boom.
Ah! Silly!
Motherfucker! I'm not a whipperist like Randy is.
Jesus Christ!
Oh!
We flew into Milan. John's bass is missing. My drum throne is missing. There's gear that just didn't show up and never showed up.
This is going to fucking suck if it carries on like this.
We kind of pull it together and, you know, okay, it doesn't feel good to be in this bus. The last couple shows didn't feel good, but tonight, you know, we're going to pull it back together and we're going to, you know, show these people what's up. The power goes out on stage.
In Italia!
Willie and John's equipment just would not work.
Our shit is going down. The equipment, you know, was bad in Japan. It was bad in Australia. Of course, it's going to be bad here. And this was one of those nights that was just completely out of our control. We couldn't do anything about it, and it was terrible.
It was a travesty!
I was done.
At a certain point, it gets so bad that you just kind of throw your hands up.
We powered through it. We did what we could do, you know. And it's just me and Mark and Chris.
You know everything's wrong, but you've only got a certain amount of time. Just hold it together, as you know, and do what we can. Sometimes doing what you can, it doesn't make up for everything that's wrong.
In the end, it's just a rock and roll show, you know, that's all it is, so you just gotta chalk it up.
Well, what can you do? That was some bull fucking shit.
Yeah, it sucked, but I mean, dude, we all came out, we tried.
We the old college dropout try.
Yeah.
You know what I'm
talking about. That's awesome, dude. It is. That's the Lamb of God motto. The old college dropout try. Just a few credits short.
Somebody has done something so atrociously wrong that we are getting a karmic smackdown right now. We got to make an offering to the gods or something.
So to recover from that, I mean, there really is no recovery to that until you play a good show.
It's hard to go backwards. Depending on where you are, you can really run into some bizarre stuff. The different countries, sometimes you stop at borders, sometimes you don't, sometimes you wake up and your money's no good, sometimes it is.
You don't have the normal conveniences in Europe that you do in the States. It can make touring much more difficult.
It just feels you're uneasy all the time. You're not anywhere comfortable. You're not at home. You can't go home.
Why are we on tour for 3 months straight? Why did we not get a break? Well, because you're building, you know. Next time we go back, we're going to be headlining this, that, and the other thing.
We were ready to go home. You know, no question about it.